My name is Roseli, and I'm going to be learning how to ride a bike. This is Nico, and he's going to be helping me. You're probably wondering why me, a girl like me, wants to ride a bike. Well, here's a couple reasons. First off, it's so much fun. You get an adrenaline rush. They're way faster than cars. You're never stuck in traffic. And a woman on a bike, like, how powerful is that? So first off, do you want to introduce yourself?
Absolutely. So I'm Nico, and we're going to be making a beginner's women's riding series here in London, the UK. And unfortunately, these bikes are just a little bit too much. So we're going to get you on a 125 after you just get your CBT.
Okay, so what is a CBT?
Right, so that's a little 5-hour kind of a pre-licensing course where they run you through the basics of how to ride. They take you out on public roads, actually, and teach you the lowdown on how to ride, make sure you're safe out there. And because you have a driving license, that gets you on the road really quickly.
Okay, so once I get my CBT, what's the next step, gear or bike?
Ooh, that's a tough one. I want to say you have to decide, what do you want to ride? Because you got vintage, you got sport, you got aggressive. What are you thinking of?
I'm thinking of aggressive.
Ooh, yeah. So these naked bikes aren't enough for you. All right, fine. So you're going to go for sport gear related. And first off, I would say, make sure you get a good bucket to protect your noggin. You know, some good jacket with pads, pants, and boots. You want to make sure you got that, check it out, that slick ankle protected. Yeah, anyway. So, yeah, that's it in terms of gear.
Okay, so obviously the next would be getting a bike. Obviously I said I want an aggressive bike, so how much would they cost and what would I be looking for when looking for a bike?
So you want to go like probably a good used route, because you might drop it once or twice and that's okay. Online you can buy something and you got the distance selling laws, so okay. Plus or minus 30 days you can return it if you just don't like it or something is wrong. You want to go for something about 1,000 to 3,000 pound range would get you a good used bike, like a Yamaha YZF 125 or perhaps even a KTM RC 125, which is definitely right my recommendation.
And what are the running costs of a bike like? Is it worth it?
Of course it's worth it. I mean, your fuel is virtually nothing. I mean, these two bikes themselves are 15 pounds to fill up for about a week's worth of riding.
And how many miles is that?
Oh, it's over 200 at least.
200, like 200 miles for 15 pounds?
Yeah.
I should have been riding all this time.
And the 125 is even more fuel efficient with about 5 pounds per week. Which is really obscene. But then you do have to worry about your insurance. Plus or minus might be 500 pounds a year, depending on you're a little bit younger than we are, which is kind of against you, unfortunately, when you're doing these things. You also have to worry about road tax when you buy a bike, but it shouldn't be more than 100 pounds per year. It's a little inconsequential. So those are your running costs.
So that's basically everything that I need to know to get started, or do you think there's any more?
Yeah, be safe.